Very bad thing. Number one, he committed adultery. Number two, he killed the husband of the woman. And then eventually even took the woman to become his wife. And a child was born. But the child didn't know anything about what David had done. We'll say the child was an innocent child. And David loved this child very much.
David defended my love for
God. God pronounced judgment upon David.
And
this thing you have done is not right. And therefore judgment will come upon you. And the Lord struck that child with sickness. And David prayed and fasted 7 days. And God will not hear that prayer. And the innocent child died of that sickness. Therefore, number one, we know there is a connection between the parents and the children. And God decided that that child in particular will not leave. Now, that's the natural aspect. You see, there are things that we parents do that affect children. Take a mother, for example, is pregnant. And this mother started smoking and drinking. There are some natural consequences on the pregnancy, on the child yet to be born. Take a mother that is pregnant and she had a particular sickness and then goes to the hospital, and the hospital, the doctor, not knowing the condition or not being very careful enough, administered a very strong drug on that pregnant woman. Although the woman may be cured from her own sickness, that strong drug may affect the fetus, may affect the child that is still inside the mother.
And
you may find that when that child is born, there is deformity. A part of that child may not be well formed.
And
it is no fault of that child. But there is the law of sowing and reaping. That therefore the actions of the parents in a natural way, in a scientific way, but logical way, may affect the children that are to be born.
There
are natural consequences. Now, the spiritual aspect. Suppose a mother or a father or the parents have given a child to the devil.
And they
have made a covenant with the devil that this child belongs to you. And they made sacrifices to seal the covenant. They made some utterances to seal the covenant. They made some incisions and marks to seal that covenant.
Or
the killed goat's animal to seal the covenant. Remember, a covenant has two parties. Although this child, innocent child, didn't know anything the parents were doing, he was not a party to the covenant. But they brought him into the covenant. He was the subject and the object of the covenant. And the parents handed over the child unto the devil. And normally the devil, that's what he wants. Because what belongs to God, he likes to usurp God's authority and take what rightfully birthday belongs to God.
Nítorí pé ọ̀yọ́ jùrọ̀ ni, n tó bá jẹ́ t'Ọlọ́run, a máa fẹ́ fi pàgbà kó lè bá di tirẹ̀.
And you know what he told Jesus?
Ó máa tó sọ fún Jésù.
He said, "Bow down to me."
Ó ní tẹríba fún mi.
All these kingdoms of the world have been handed over to me.
Ó ní gbogbo ìjọba ayé yìí o, ìkáwọ́ mi ló wà.
And you know what it says in 2 Corinthians chapter 4? It says, "The devil, the god of this world."
Ó máa tó sọ nu Corinthi kejì orí kẹrin pé èsù ọmọ aládé ayé yìí.
And Jesus said, "The prince of this world cometh and has nothing in me."
Jésù sọ pé ọmọ aládé ayé yìí wá sọ́dọ̀ mi kò rí nǹkan nínú mi.
When did the world become the property of the devil that God was the one that created the world?
Nígbà wo wá láyé wá di ohun ìní Sátani? Nígbà tó jẹ́ pé Ọlọ́run ló ṣẹ̀dá ayé yìí.
When God created the world,
nígbà tó Ọlọ́run ṣẹ̀dá ayé yìí,
he handed it over to Adam.
Ó fi lé Ádámù lọ́wọ́.
And said, "Have dominion over it."
Ó ní máa jọba lórí rẹ̀.
But Adam sold it to the devil.
Ṣùgbọ́n Ádámù wá tà fún èṣù.
And said, and you know, he bowed down with Eve, and then it came into the hands of the devil.
Rántí pé wọ́n tú bá wọn tẹríba fún èṣù, òun àti aya rẹ̀, ó wá dohun ìní
èṣù báyìí. And Jesus said, "A covenant had been made. God, the devil now is the prince of the power of the air, is the god of this world. It has been handed over to him." And the devil himself said, "All the kingdoms of the world, they are handed over to me. If you want anything there, bow down, I'll give you a little."
Jesus sọ wípé ayé yìí o májẹ̀mú ti wà níbẹ̀ torí pé àwọn ènìyàn tí a fi fún ti tà fún èṣù. Nítorí bẹ́ẹ̀ ló sọ pé ọmọ aládé òfurufú, ọmọ aládé ayé yìí ó wá sọ́dọ̀ òun. Torí bẹ́ẹ̀ lèṣù náà sọ pé gbogbo ayé yìí ìkáwọ́ òun ló wà tẹríba fún òun.
It's God who created that little child.
Ọlọ́run ló dá ọmọ kékeré yẹn.
But he put that little child in care of the parents.
Ó wá fi sọ́wọ́ àwọn òbí.
And the parents handed over that child to the devil in covenant.
Àwọn òbí fúnra wọn wá fi ọmọ yẹn sínú májẹ̀mú pẹ̀lú èṣù.
And the devil knows what has been handed over to him.
Èṣù ó sì mọ nǹkan tá a fi fún òun.
And the devil is still holding on to that.
Èṣù àwa máa di eléyìí mú.
Now our young boy has become born again.
Ní báyìí ọ̀dọ́kùnrin wa ti wá dàtún bí.
What did he do in being born again?
Kí ló ṣe nígbà tí ó di àtún bí?
He didn't touch anything that the parents did was the devil. All that he touched is that, "Oh Lord, I have been stealing. I will not steal again. I've been having girlfriend. No girlfriend again. I've been smoking. I will not smoke again. I've been doing this. I've been doing that. Please forgive me." He dealt with the issue that concerned himself. Of the covenant that anybody made with anybody, and they say, and Satan still saying, "Well, you can be born again. That's between you and God. Your soul can be redeemed. But they already made covenant with me that you will not marry, that you are given to me, and that when you get to this age, this is what I'll do. You are my property. Go and repent. Go to church. That's all right. But there is a covenant." And this child is not touching covenant. It's not touching anything. All that this child is doing, "I will not steal again. I will not smoke again. I will not fight. I will not do this. Forgive my sins. I want to be born again."
ọmọkùnrin tó dàtún bí nígbà tó fẹ́ di àtún bí ohun tó kàn sọ fọlọ́run ni pé ọlọ́run mo ti ń jalè tẹ́lẹ̀ olúwa dáríjì mi mo ti ń yàlè tẹ́lẹ̀ olúwa dáríjì mi àwọn irọ́ tí mò ń pa tẹ́lẹ̀ olúwa dáríjì mi gbogbo àwọn májẹ̀mú eléyìí tí àwọn òbí rẹ̀ bá èṣù dá tàbí tí ẹnikẹ́ni bá èṣù dá nítorí rẹ̀ kò sọ nǹkan kan nípa yẹn nítorí náà ìtọ́ àwa ni kò burú ní ti pé kò dà tó bí kò lọ sọ́ọ̀sì mo yọ̀ǹda rẹ mọ́ sí yẹn a lè rọkàn rẹ padà ṣùgbọ́n ní ti májẹ̀mú táwọn òbí ẹ tá a jọ ní pé ń jọba òní rọkọ fẹ́ tàbí òní ráya fẹ́ tàbí ń gbọ́ bá pé iye ọdún báyìí màá fi mú ẹfọn fèrè gbogbo májẹ̀mú yẹn sì wà mẹ́ o òun fúnra ara rẹ̀ nígbà tó dẹ̀ẹ́dẹ́ ní ìgbàlà gbogbo májẹ̀mú yẹn kò sí nǹkan kan tó ṣe nípa rẹ̀.
If it is just on the side of the Lord alone, that's very easy and simple.
Tó bá jẹ́ pé ní ìhà t'Ọlọ́run nìkan ni ìyẹn rọrùn.
But the devil is holding on to the fact that this is what your father told me. This is what your mother told me. Your father, your mother gave you to me, made a covenant with me, and you have not done anything about it.
Ṣùgbọ́n ní ìhà àti èṣù ṣe ló ń fapá jánú pé bàbá rẹ àti màmá rẹ májẹ̀mú tí wọ́n ti ṣe pẹ̀lú mi ni. Àdéhùn tí a ti jọ nínú ò dẹ̀ sí nǹkan kan nípa irú májẹ̀mú bẹ́ẹ̀.
And so when a child like that gets born again.
Nítorí náà nígbà tí irú ọmọ bẹ́ẹ̀ bá wá dàtún bí.
If he knows of any covenant.
Tí òun bá mọ̀ nípa májẹ̀mú kankan.
If he knows of any agreement.
Tí òun bá mọ̀ nípa àdéhùn kádéhùn.
If the parents tell him that, "Ah, you are going to church. They are not going to church. What we have already decided before you were born, this is what we said, this is what we did. Now that child knows there is something I need to deal with. I've dealt with my own part, my stealing, my drunkenness, my smoking and all that. See what my parents are telling me. I must deal with this one.
Mo ti yanju ipa temi o nipa ti pe ka jale ka ma sagbere gbogbo yen ni mo ti yanju pelu Olorun sugba wa won tawo obi mi se mo lati yanju eleyi.
In 1 Chronicles chapter 4.
Chronica kini ori kerin.
Reading from verse 9.
Aoka lati ese ikese.
And Jabez was more honorable than his brethren.
Jabez si se olola ju awon ara
ko. And his mother called his name Jabez.
Iya re si pe oruko re ni Jabez.
Saying, because I bear him in sorrow.
Wi pe nitori mo bi pelu ibanuje.
His child Jabez when he was born.
Omo ti a pe ni Jabez nigba ti a bi.
There were sorrowful things surrounding the birth.
Awon kan banuje lo yi ibi re
ba. As he was growing up,
bo se wa n dagba,
he realized that things were happening that brought sorrow.
O ri pe awon nkan to sele si won fa ibanuje.
And the mother told him the story.
But mama re wa so itan na fun.
This was the conditions surrounding when you were born.
Nkan to sele ni nigba ta bi o.
That's why these things are happening.
Idi ti nkan wo ye tin sele ni.
Even the name we give you, don't you understand our language?
Oruko ta so eyan gan o mo pe ile lawo ka to so mo loruko
yin. Didn't you understand that when you hear this name in our language, this is the meaning?
Se ko yo wi pe to ba ti gbo oru oruko bayi itumo to ma nje ni nile de wa.
So Jabez said, ah, so that's what happened. Now in verse
10,
Jabez called on the.
Now it's in
the same area with children that have disobeyed and have offended their parents when they were very young.
Oun kan na lo sele pelu awon omo ti won sa igboran si awon obi won nigba ti won wa lewe.
And those parents became angry.
Awon obi yen inu wa bi won lopolopo.
And in their anger.
Ninu ibinu won.
Because you know there are times in the family.
Omo igba mi wa ninu ebi.
Take a father for example.
Ka fi baba sapere.
And this father may be had two wives.
Boya baba yi o wa ni iya mi iyawo meji.
And the one of the children of the women maybe felt that the father was not treating his own mother very well. And with the kind of rebellion that teenagers have, the child came from school. And he felt that, why is this man treating my mother like this? And he decided to fight it out for the father. And as he became insulting and rude, the father then looked at the child and said, that's how your children will do to you. You will not have settled home. And the child just said, that is your own. My own will not be illiterate marriage. And then the child now grew up. And now he says he's even born again. Now he says he's married. And then a lot of things are happening. No matter how he goes this direction, that direction, every direction, he sees that there is no settlement in the home. And he just feels that, well, I'm not a Christian. I don't understand why these problems are there. Do you remember that
Jacob,
when he was about to die, he called his firstborn
Reuben.
He looked at him. He said, this one, unstable as water. He went to the bed of his father. And he went to be with one of those women. He laid a curse on him. You know, there are many, many things that happen in life. That, you know, after people grow up, they just shrug their shoulders and say, no problem, no problem, there is problem. Now, when you come to the Lord, you know that some things like that have happened, either there was a covenant made by your parents that sold you into the hand of the devil, or it was a curse from maybe one of your parents or the elders. When you come to the Lord, you will deal with the problem. And you can deal with that problem. I said you can deal with that problem. There are other people who are in the world who are not Christians. They cannot deal with the problem. But when you are a believer, you can deal with that problem. Isaiah chapter 10 verse 27. And it shall come to pass in that day that his burden shall be taken away from thy shoulder, and his yoke from off thy neck, and the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing.
Ati ajaga re kuro le orun re a o si ba ajaga na je nitori ora pupo tabi nitori ifami ororo yan.
This is one of the reasons why God gave power and authority to the church.
Idi gan niyan tabi okan ninu idi ti Olorun si fi agbara ati ase fun ijo.
We don't have the time to go into details.
A o lanfani lati lo yanju re leyo kankan.
But you see, there is a major difference between the church and Israel.
O je mo pe iyato to lagbara lo wa laarin ijo ati Israeli.
And there are problems that the church needs to deal with that Israel did not have to deal with. No, there are problems that the church now has to settle, but Israel did not have any necessity of settling such a problem. When you are talking of the church, you are talking of people that are called out from Gentile nations, from idolatrous background, from making covenant with the devil, from Mami Wata and all that. The members of the church, they are people that came away, they came out of all those backgrounds to come and serve the Lord.
For
the children of Israel, when God brought them out of the land of Egypt, he even told them the kind of food they will eat, the kind of marriage they will have, how they will make their farm, how they will not worship idol. And as long as they were keeping to all those things, many of the children, they didn't know any bad thing. But in the case of the church now, you have a lot of people that are coming from bad, evil background. And when they come in with a lot of these problems, you need to deal with the problem.
So Barati and Sally Penny back in one jade crony LGBT. A lot of less of one day before you won't get in one jet. Be what a dark one. I want cutting what you must say, go go away, Lana, you know a lot of people want. So about that thing, far away, Lana, Ima, or follow up on round, I want my one new tier, my it's a Jalut, Abi Bikaka. So when it is friendly, and it is Joba, it's a Jape, Latin, a bit of Luby, I want a lot of people, why you know, follow up on what you got, you need to know, follow up on what.
This is the reason why God gave the key, the authority, the power to the church. I told you, either that they made a sacrifice to seal the covenant. And then they made an utterance saying, this person now belongs to you. There are two things there that are very important to that covenant. One, the sacrifice they made. Two, the words they uttered. Now, the covenant is supposed to be broken. Because now Christ has made a sacrifice, that higher sacrifice nullifies the lower sacrifice.
Nitori pe Christ ti wa se irubo to ga julo irubo to ga julo yen o ti wa ba irubo ti o to nkan
yen. That's why they overcame him by the blood of the lamb. It's the higher sacrifice that annuls, that cancels, that destroys the lower sacrifice.
O so pe won si segun re nipa ejo odo agutan iyan ni pe majemu eleyi ti o ga irubo to ga julo eleyi ti Jesu ti se yen o lo wa ba gbogbo ebo ti o to nkan lo baje.
Two, they made an utterance when they were making the covenant.
Ekeji ni pe won so awon oro kan jade nigba ti won se majemu na.
And you need a higher word to cancel the lower word.
O wa nilo oro to ga lati pa oro kekeke.
And therefore you take the very word of the Lord himself.
Wa wa mu oro Olorun fun ara re.
Where the word of the king is, there is power, there is authority. And now you have the key. That whatsoever you bind on earth is bound in heaven. That is, they have made this person to just be roaming about. He will not sit inside any home. She will marry this one and leave and go to another place and go to another place and go to another place. She can never be tied down to a family. She will never stay inside one home. Now you bind what they have loosed and say a higher word cancels the lower word. Get married, sit down.
Until what you say, ni wi pe eni won fe ko ma si lati le oko kan bo si ni to ba ti de bi bayi ko tun ni te lorun a tun lo sodo oko miran ohun ti won se ni pe ko sa ma ti le oko kan bo si miran ko ma ni ebi to toro nisisin yi ohun ti won wa ti tun yen iwa wa de wi pe oya joko si le oko re.
The one they are bound in sickness, the one they are bound in poverty, the one they are bound that he will never make it, he'll never progress, you lose nothing and say go free.
Anything what you do, you know, son. Anything what you do, you know, I read your remo. Iwawa turu eni na sile kwe ma loni omenera.
Now, after you have done that,
lẹ́yìn ìgbà tó bá ti wá sí lẹ́yìn.
There is now something you need in your own heart.
Ohun kan wà tó nílò nínú ọkàn rẹ.
You know those people that make the covenant.
So mà àwọn tí wọ́n máa ń dá májẹ̀mú káàkiri.
When those parents handed over that child to the devil.
Nígbà tí àwọn òbí yẹn ti ń fa ọmọ yẹn léṣu lọ́wọ́.
You know something?
Wọ́n mọ nǹkan kan.
They actually believe.
Wọ́n gbàgbọ́ nínú ọkàn wọn.
That child now will be controlled by the devil.
Pé èsù ni ó máa ṣàkóso ọmọ yẹn láéláé.
That's why those parents will call the child.
Ìdí ni ẹ̀dá àwọn òbí yẹn á ti pọ́nmọ yẹn.
They will say whatever you read in the book, that one is book, but the one we have done, they believe with strong conviction that nothing they have done with the devil, that nothing will stand.
Ìdí ni ẹ̀dá àwọn òbí yẹn á ti sọ fún pé ohun tó bá wù kó máa kà nù òwe ìwé nìyẹn ṣùgbọ́n ìdá wa ti ṣe yẹn wọ́n gbàgbọ́ pẹ̀lú ìdánilójú tó lágbára wípé eléyìí ò tèṣù ní ṣe.
Come, look at the spot of the idol, something, the shrine, where we made you to kneel down, where we gave you over. Go anywhere, go America, go Britain, go Japan. Well, if you don't listen to what we're saying, we have said it already. They believe implicitly.
What ye pe pe ah? Oje wa wo? Oju ba ori sata ti dana je mu yeni? Oba lo America? Oba lo London? Eto uko se nibe? Talk when we begin to watch you go.
Now, you have come to the Lord.
Nibayi, what you are, what
the higher sacrifice cancels the lower sacrifice. The higher word operates on the lower word and removes the lower word. Now, faith in Christ cancels faith in Satan.
Ìgbàgbọ́ nínú Kristi a máa pa ìgbàgbọ́ nínú Sátani run.
Immediately you are prayed for and you yourself, you have opened your mouth, you said, I'm no more in that thing, I do not accept anything anymore like that. Oh Lord, change my life, enlarge my cause, let there not be not evil against me anymore. You believe in your heart more than they are believing their own covenant, and you'll be free in Jesus' name.
Lẹ́sẹ̀kẹsẹ̀ tí a bá gbàdúrà fún ọ ni wọ́n gbà pa nínú ọkàn rẹ ni wà á ti gbàgbọ́ wípé ní báyìí o ìṣẹ́gun ti dé kò sí ìbànújẹ́ mọ́ kò sí òsì mọ́ olúwa yóò sọ ẹ̀ka àmì di ńlá
Christ has died for you already. The word of the Lord gives you assurance. If you believe today, you are going to see the glory of God. And he says, you will serve the Lord. The Lord your God. He will bless your bread. And he will bless your water. And then he will take sickness from the midst of thee. Then he says, nothing shall cast their young. And the number of your days I will fulfill. He says, if you diligently hearken unto me, to observe and to do all these things that I have commanded you, I will put none of these diseases upon you, which I brought upon the Egyptians. For I am the Lord that healeth thee. And then he tells us that he died on the cross, hanged on the tree, so that we might be righteous through him, by whose stripes ye were healed. Today you can be healed, and you will praise the name of the Lord. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. He forgiveth all thine iniquities. He healeth all thy diseases. Can he not do it today? I said, can he do it today? Rise up and let us pray. Whatever covenant the Lord can remove it today. Whatever yoke the Lord can break it today. Whatever sin the evil people of the world have said any curse, the Lord can remove it today. Trust in the Lord, believe in the Lord. If you are now born again, if you are now a child of God, if they have given you into the hands of the devil before, if they have made a covenant on your behalf before, you now open your mouth and tell the Lord, I reject that covenant. I reject that covenant. All those evil things I refuse. I now belong to the Lord. I am now a child of God. You devil, I do not belong to you. I cancel that covenant. I remain with the Lord now. With the blood of the Lamb, I am free. With the blood of the Lamb, I am free. By the anointing, the yoke of my life is broken. The yoke of my life is broken. I am free. I am free. I am free.
Say you're free. Declare it with your mouth. I am free. Say, I'm free from every curses. I'm free from every limitation. I'm free from every evil prophecy. Free from every evil decree. The blood of Jesus has set me free. In the name of Jesus. And as you decree you are free, so shall it be in Jesus' name. And nothing shall hold you bound in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. For in Jesus' name we pray. Let's share the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Say to your neighbor, I am free and no longer bound. I am free and no longer bound. Amen. God bless you all in Jesus' name.